funeral services for Jersey Bridgeman ended just 2 hours ago. More than 200 people mourned the six-year-old. 42.9's Tony Russell tells us they remembered a little girl who loved her family. He's live and local from near the Bentonville Cemetery where Jersey was laid to rest.
It was just a few hours ago when that funeral services just wrapped up here. She was laid to rest here at the Bentonville Cemetery, and people coming out say she was just a little girl that loved life.
She was always smiling. She was outgoing. Just loved her to death.
Friends, family, and even law enforcement showed up to pay their last respects for six-year-old Jersey Bridgeman. Jersey's funeral procession got a special police escort by the Bentonville Police Department.
There's closure a little bit.
In time, there will be. And I think she'll always be remembered no matter what.
Friends say six-year-old Jersey was a loving little girl.
She's been through a lot. She was very quiet. But, you know, she always laughed. She had the biggest smile that you could have. She made sure she showed you her teeth. And she loved her parents and all of her family more than anything.
Jersey's funeral comes exactly 1 week from when Bentonville Police Department found her lying dead in a vacant Bentonville home. We're live tonight. Tony Russell, 4029 News.
And tonight we're learning more about the man arrested in Jersey's death. This is Zachary Hawley. He was Jersey's next door neighbor and lived in the house between hers and the vacant home where her body was found. And this is video from outside that house. That's Zachary Hawley in the blue hat as police searched the area. Hawley has been arrested three times before, once for public intoxication and twice for contempt of court. Hawley is in the Benton County Jail tonight. He'll have a bond hearing tomorrow. Now, we just talked to the court, and Judge Robin Green will not let our camera in the courtroom.